two follow along with the how much fresh water is on Earth. But first, I want to highlight where I am standing. I am in downtown Olympia right now at the local wastewater treatment plant called Lot Clean Water Alliance. We are cleaning up the dirty water for Lacey, Olympia, Tumwater, all that are in Thurston County. Take a look around and see some of the systems that we use to clean up wastewater. It's pretty awesome. We decided to come inside to the Wet Science Center to show you our experiment about how much fresh water is available on Earth. And conveniently standing behind our precious water. Our water is so precious, and it's important that we're taking care of it. We're going to be figuring out how much water is actually on Earth. And here we have all the water on Earth. First, I would like you to follow along with the instructions here. If you can't do this, then you can just follow what I'm doing and fill in the answers as you go. First, writing your labels, then filling up a jar or a bowl with 1,000 milliliters of water. This represents all the water we have on Earth. So imagine water in oceans, in lakes, in rivers, all in this one jar. We have two kinds of water on Earth. What are the two kinds of water? You'll write those in right here. Think about it, write in your answers. There's fresh and salt water. We'll be measuring out how much of this is salt and fresh. To start, you'll be taking a tablespoon, pulling out 2 tablespoons, and putting it into the fresh water cup. Now, this represents the salt water on Earth. Add a pinch of salt. And this here represents the fresh water on Earth. Now, not all the fresh water is available to us. It's not all liquid. We'll be taking out 2 teaspoons of that. Now we have our total liquid water. And this fresh water is somewhere that is very cold. Water, when it's very cold, turns into what? Ice, snow, glaciers. And we can't access that water because it's frozen. Now think about where all the liquid water is. On number 3, you'll be writing down 3 places that you can find fresh water. Think about where might you see or find fresh water. Rivers, lakes, even underground, in ponds, in the air, in the rain. And we can't access all that water. Maybe it's because it's really hard for us to get to. Maybe it's because it's not clean. From our total liquid, you will dip your finger in and let 1 or 2 drops fall into your clean and available. About 1 drop of all of this water is clean and available. Again, this is just representing, if we were to put all of the Earth's water into this jar in here, it's not very much, which is why it's so important that we take care of this water. And all of the water we have, the salt and the fresh water, is moving through the water cycle. And the rest of this packet, you will get to follow along with some water cycle activities. Have fun, scientists.